Good morning, everybody. Everybody ready?
Yes.
Good morning. I'd like to welcome you here and thank you for being here. I'm here with Deputy Chief Barty, Officer Steve Farrell, Commander Louis Dabdu of the Reserve Division. You've all heard me say that we're using every available resource to combat violent crime in the city of New Orleans, every neighborhood in the city of New Orleans, and we're using that to rebuild our police force. We created a 16-member task force that we're deploying every night of the week throughout the city to combat violent crime. So far, we've transferred 25 members of the department from administrative duties back into the field where they're now patrolling. We've doubled the amount of overtime that we're using to help combat violent crime. So far, as you know, we're aggressively recruiting, we're aggressively hiring. We have 58 recruits that are in the academy right now in two separate classes. We have 26 recruits that are in field training in the field, soon to be graduated from field training very soon. We passed a 5% across-the-board raise for our police officers. It's the first raise we've had in over 8 years. That's going to help us recruit and retain police officers. And now we're calling on former members of the police department to come home to NOPD to help us keep our city safe. Last fall, I asked Commander Dabdu to return to the Reserve Division. He graciously accepted that call to be the commander of the Reserve, and I'm confident he's going to help us lead in recruiting new Reserve officers and rebuilding the police department. So this is an opportunity to make a difference in our community. Reserve officers are unpaid. They're volunteer police officers who can do anything that any other paid police officer can do, but they provide that additional manpower that we so desperately need at such a critical time. The seasoned officers bring an incredible amount of experience and knowledge to the field. They're very well equipped. They possess the same equipment that we have, the same training. In fact, right now we're deploying reserve officers every night of the week into different parts of the city. By and large in the French Quarter, and they are patrolling and they are helping us to combat crime and are positively affecting that crime. Here's how it works. It's open to all former NOPD officers who have retired or resigned from the department in good standing. Applicants must successfully complete a background investigation. Once accepted, they'll be reinstated at the rank which they left, up to the rank of captain. For the first time in a long time, reserve officers now get a $500 uniform allowance. We started that this year, and they were very grateful for that, and that's going to go a long way. So this Saturday at 10 o'clock, we're hosting an informational meeting right here at NOPD headquarters. For anyone who's interested in joining our reserve division or anyone interested to returning to the NOPD to join our reserve division, if you're a former officer and you have a desire to serve your community and you want to come home to this family, we welcome you back. And right now, I'd like to turn it over to Commander Dabdu.
Sure. Thank you very much, Superintendent. I want to thank you for this opportunity, and from all of us who have been members of the department and who have always yearned to continue to serve after we retire, this is an incredible opportunity. I can tell you that with the initial phone calls we made out to officers who've left recently and retired or resigned in good standing, the response has been overwhelming. The amount of calls we've been getting and the excitement about this opportunity has been incredible, quite honestly. Open arm invitation is that we're asking officers to return at their former rank, whatever they retired up to the level of police captain, which is one heck of an honor. I can tell you from being a retired police officer myself, it isn't what you did for a living, it was who you are, and it never leaves you. All of these men and women who've left here, who came on this police department, are service-minded individuals. It's the type of individual we need and want back in this department. So my clear message that I've said before and will continue to say, we need you and we want you. Thank you very much. Chief?
On topic questions?
Chief, roughly how many people do you think are going to take up this offer?
I think right now we are slightly above 70 that are active reservists, And since I became superintendent, I probably have had 10 or 12 letters written to me asking to be reinstated as a reserve officer. And so, you know, obviously I sent those to recruitment, sent those to reserve to begin processing, to make sure those folks were in good standing and that they were able to successfully rejoin this department. So we're working through that, and we think that with the phone calls that have gone out, we've been very proactive. Commander Dabdu, Officer Harrell, they're doing a phenomenal job. They're doing exactly what we thought they would do. This is the vision to grow the department, and this was the right leadership that we chose to help to make that happen. They're doing a phenomenal job. We believe that we're going to be successful, that there are members who have an interest in coming back, and now that this leadership is in place, we look forward to welcoming those officers home.
Can you explain how the detail work works? If you work a certain amount of hours, you can qualify to work paid detail, and does that help fill a gap as far as details are concerned as well, and make it so that there's enough officers to fulfill all the jobs that are out there and need detail work?
Absolutely. So the requirement now is reserve officers are required to be in good standing to work 24 hours a month. And once they fulfill that requirement, they are eligible to work paid details, just like our paid police officers. And there's a requirement for the amount of hours they can work 24 hours per week. So that does become a force multiplier, and that does help with visibility. It does help with staffing shortages that we may have from time to time. And so they become extremely valuable. Many of them have full-time careers, and they dedicate their spare time and give it back to the community. I think that's very admirable.
What if the person says, okay, I'll come back, but it's kind of risky, no pay. I know there aren't any benefits. The only benefit would be, I guess, the being able to work the reserve off-duty, whatever. So what do you think about that? How can you convince them to come here, even 36 hours with no pay, no benefits? Is that enough of a carrot to say you can make a little extra cash?
There's something about a police officer. First of all, none of us ever signed up for pay. We signed up to serve. We signed up to protect. We signed up to do what's right. And it's never been about pay. And for those who spent a career here, like Commander Dabdu, it's never been about pay. They volunteer their hours. And if you see the reserve officers that are out there every night patrolling for free, it's not about pay. And they incur the same risk that we see and incur every single day. And it's something about their character. It won't be about pay. It'll be about the love of NOPD, the love of the city, and the desire to be a police officer.
So 70 reservists now, you got some phone calls, and you say you've had some overwhelming response?
It's been overwhelming.
Tell me what overwhelming.
Sure. Steve and I were just talking this morning. The phones barely stop ringing. I've personally spoken to over 30 officers who've expressed a desire and will be here on Saturday. That does not include the remaining of the officers that aren't. She said we're currently at 7 officers. To get into the triple digits back by the is easy for us to do, and we can dream big, and there's no limit to where it can go. I'm gonna, you know, it's kind of hard to put a hard number on it, but it has been even greater than we had hoped for.
Lou, can you talk about what you missed about the job? You were a high-profile officer, commander of the 8th, commander of the 4th, and then you went away to do other work. What did you miss most about being an NOPD officer, and what did you hope to fulfill once you came back?
That's an easy question to answer, and I'll be honest with you. It's at the core of why I did come back. The chief did an extremely good job of explaining what benefits it is to come to do this. When you become a police officer, it was never done because you thought you would be rich one day, because you'd be famous one day. It was because you have something inside of you that was instilled by God that made you feel proud, that made you stand up and realize what you were born for. And it was to go out and to serve. To go out to a scene where someone called for assistance when they're in their most desperate time, when they're in fear, when they've been victimized, when they're hurt and they're scared and they don't know where to turn. And to be able to go there and provide them the help they need at their most desperate times is the most incredible feeling I can describe. I've often described it over my years. It's like the old e-ticket ride at Disney World. It's an incredible feeling, an incredibly fulfilling feeling to be able to go and help someone when they need it most. It's something that can't be replaced, you can't put a price tag on. It's an unbelievable opportunity, and we want to invite all of our ex-op members who know exactly what that feeling is to come back to be a part of it. We want you, and we need you.
Chief, would you say that the fact that you're getting so many inquiries is somewhat of a reflection on an improving morale in the ranks? I know a lot of officers were fed up in under the old regime and left because of that. Do you see things turning around in that regard?
I do. I've been seeing it for a while. All of you have been seeing it. It's definitely connected to morale, and despite what the naysayers are saying, I never listen to that. You shouldn't either. Morale is high. People are asking to come back. I get letters every day asking to be reinstated to full-time, reinstated to the reserves. The performance is high out there in the field. Officers are actively pursuing criminals, and we're making arrests on armed robbery after armed robbery, violent crime after violent crime. The officers are pursuing relentlessly and are doing what they can do to regain the citizens' trust and to make our city safe. Performance is a byproduct of morale, and that high performance indicates that they're engaged, they're enthused, they see the light at the end of the tunnel, we're moving forward, and I would say that morale is improving. It's far better than it was, and we look to make it even better. This is a great opportunity for Commander Dabdu and Chief Bardi and our staff to increase morale even more, because as we bring more reserve officers on, it relieves the stress of the officers who are out there performing and carrying that load right now. So morale is much better. I feel better about it. I think we all do.
Are you accepting transfers as well from other departments?
Yeah. Absolutely. Absolutely. There are officers who have asked to come from other police departments, and if they're in good standing, we welcome them to the reserves and to our full ranks. So we look forward to that as well.
How many officers, you said some have asked to come back full-time, how many have they'll be going into?
Right now, the reserves have, because we have a task force that's going all over the city, 60-member task force, we've utilized the reserves in and around the French Quarter, side streets, the back streets. They've been very effective with that. They've been very visible. In early December, we had a spike in robberies through the holiday season, and even after the holidays, they were very instrumental in helping us curtail that and increasing our visibility. And so while we deploy across the city, we compartmentalize and put different units in different places, and we assign them to the French Quarter area.
All right, thanks, guys.
Is there anything you can say about the Irish?